Whether in the studio or live stream, we work hard to help you strengthen your body and to support your mind. We're happy you decided to come on this journey with us during this challenging time, and we're pleased to offer you live stream classes every day. We've worked hard to bring this digital library for you to be able to work out with us whenever you want. And we're going to continue to work to improve our content. So please let me introduce you to your instructor for your class today.
All right, ladies, here we are. I'm scooting over to my mat here. And I always like to begin really the same way. And that's just really kind of melting your body into the mat. And breathing, just initially at your own pace. So nice deep full inhales and full exhales. And starting to feel everything sort of release as much as possible. Noticing where the body is. Notice areas of tension that might have cropped up. And breathing into those areas. And releasing on the exhale. And as you breathe, starting to feel the spine lengthen along the mat, through the crown of the head and down through the sacrum, creating space in between each of those vertebra. And the feet are flat on the mat. You feel all four points of the foot. Feeling the base of the low back, the natural curve of the spine. Feel the heaviness of the middle back, so sinking the sternum down. Dropping the shoulders down and away from the ears and lengthening through the neck. And let's take it into a more active breath. We'll inhale deeply under the belly button and all the way around the spine. And on our exhale, we're actively drawing all of those muscles into center. And again, inhale. And we exhale to draw everything in around the spine. And a few more, nice, full inhale. And a full exhale to draw everything in around the spine, around that neutral spine. And again, nice, full inhale. And exhale. Last one, deep, full inhale. And exhale. Muscles are activated all the way around that neutral spine. And let's take the breath a little less intense, okay? Take it into our Pilates breath, but we're gonna inhale. And on our exhale, we're actively just pulling that pelvis toward us and it's tilt. We're gonna inhale to rock it away. Just back into neutral spine and exhale to draw the pelvis toward us, tilting it north. And inhale, rock it away. And again, so just loosening up the low back muscles, very gentle pelvic rock. And exhale to pull the pelvis towards you. Inhaling to release. And again, exhale. Inhale. And last one, we exhale. And inhale into neutral spine. And I'm going to have you actually take your hands, palms are going to face each other. And the base of the palm is going to go right onto your hip, those hip bones here in the front. And we're going to lift our right hip up toward the ceiling. And you can see your hand go up just about an inch. And then we're going to pull it back to center. And then we're going to lift the left side up and pull it back down. So now we're rocking the pelvis back and forth, side to side. And lift and lower. And lift. And lower, and one more each side. We've got the right side lifting up, pull it back down, and the left side lift and lower it down. Beautiful. Arms come back down to the sides. Inhale here for me. Exhale, draw the muscles around neutral spine and lift the right leg up in knee hold. And we inhale to lower it down slow and smooth. And left side lift and lower, and right side lift. And lower right from the hip flexor. When we lift our leg up, that shin is parallel with the ceiling. And left side lift and lower. and lift, marching here, and left side lift, and lower. And then we're gonna bring our right leg up, and our left comes up to meet it, arms come out into T position, and we're gonna drop our knees all the way over to the right, and look at our left hand, and stretch it here. And bring our legs up, and dropping the knees over to the left. Looking at our right hand, feeling that lovely stretch in the low back. And inhaling, the legs come back up, arms come down to the sides, and then we're gonna float our feet back down to center. We're gonna actually just separate our feet a little bit again, hip distance. Arms are gonna come out a little bit to give us room. And we're gonna just drop the right hip open and feel a stretch through the inner thigh. And pull that leg back up and then dropping down the left side. And we'll do one more each side, pulling the left leg up, the right leg drops down, opening through the hip, through the inner thigh. Right leg comes up and left side goes down. And bringing the left side up, bringing the feet and legs together now and dropping both hips open. Sometimes this can be a little intense, so if you need to hold on to the legs to kind of feel that release, that's perfectly all right. Kind of just going to where that feels good to you, where you feel a nice opening. And bring everything back to center. Go ahead and take the feet out again, hip distance. Feel them in the mat. Arms come up into ribcage position. We're gonna just go right into angel arms. We're lifting our arms up to our ears, noticing the sternum sinking down and staying very stable here. Inhale, exhale to pull the arms down to the waist. Inhale again, arms all the way up to the ears. Exhale, pull the arms down. So our arm attached to the scapula and really feeling the motion of the scapula moving in the back. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, armpit muscles are used to pull the arms down. Two more, inhale, exhale. Inhale, arms come up. Exhale, bring our arms into ribcage position. Inhale here, exhale, arms down to the waist, changing directions. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, arms all the way down. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, arms down. Good, you guys. Inhale, exhale, arms down. One more. Exhale, arms down. Now we add on. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, as the arms float down, the head floats up, we hold for one, two. Arms come up, inhale. Exhale, abdominals pull in and use them to float your upper body up. Reach through the fingertips. And inhale, arms up. And we exhale, arms down again, abdominal curl, hold here, one, two. Last one, inhale. And we exhale to come up. Right from here, we just rest our body down, arms down at the sides. We're going right into bridging, inhaling here, and exhaling to tilt the pelvis first to roll up to our shoulder blades. Now we're gonna pause here and pull our legs in a little bit closer so heels are moving toward the butt. We lift up just a teeny bit higher, still feeling the middle back of the mat, feeling the neck long and tension free. And we're gonna march it right here. So we're gonna pull the right leg up. Pelvis is stable and bring it down. And then the left side lifts. And we lower it down and right. And down. Good. And left. And lower. And right. And down. And left. And down. Good. And right. And down. And left. And down. Hold here. Pull the feet together. And pull the knees together and lift up into releve. And if you need to, pull the legs closer to your butt again. And we're gonna open to the side in a clam and pull it closed. And inhale. inhale, open, exhale, draw everything to center. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Take it up to pace now, open and close. Open and close. Open and close. Feel the glutes activated. Hamstrings very activated here. And close, and three more. And two. And one, squeeze, drop the heels, inhale and exhale, roll down through the spine. We're gonna do another set just like that. Inhale and exhale to roll back up, articulate through. Feel the middle back here and lift up onto the toes in releve. Heels are up and we open and close. Up to pace now, open and close. And three, squeeze, and four. Squeeze, good. Five, six, seven, we'll do 10, and eight. Last two, nine, squeeze, and 10. Squeeze, inhale, and exhale to roll it back down. And draw the knees into the chest, stretch it up. And even give your hips a little rock back and forth if you need to. Just a light massage in the low back. And then we bring our knees into tabletop position. Going right into the hunter, you guys. Here we go. Arms come up, palms facing the opposite wall. Inhale, exhale, draw the abdominals and use them to lift your body up. Float it up. Reach through the fingertips, bringing your legs out to your hunter position. And here we go. Inhale for one, two, three, four, five. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Exhale, two, three, four, five. Inhale, two, three, four, five. Exhale, reach further through those fingertips. Good. Pump the arms, yes. Inhale, two, three, four, five. Exhale, two, three, four, five. One more set. Exhale. And bring the knees into the chest. Head goes down. The right leg goes out long on the mat. The left leg goes up, pointing through the toe, arms at the sides. Inhale and exhale. Restabilize your center and then circle around the midline of the body and pause. And two. And three. Good. And four. And five. And six. Pause. Take it the other direction for one. And two. And three. Four, good, five, and last one, six. Switching the legs in a scissor motion and circling the midline first for one, two, three, four, five, and six, and take it the other direction, one. Good, pausing in between each one, so we're not using momentum, we're using all of that good muscle energy. And last two, and last one. Good, you guys, and bringing the leg down, and then I'm gonna scoot back just a little bit. Legs are long and together and zipped up tight. Flex the feet for this roll up, okay? And arms come up into your ribcage position. We're gonna inhale. On our exhale, nod the chin forward just a bit. Start to peel the spine up. You're going up to wherever you can. If you can come all the way up and over those feet, do. And stretch here, staying round in that C-curved spine. Inhale, and we exhale to actively come back down. Reach to the opposite wall so that you have that control motion down. And again, inhale, and we exhale to come up. And we reach over the feet. Inhale, exhale, deepen that abdominal connection to come back down. Reach one vertebra at a time, slow and smooth. Inhale and exhale. Reaching over the feet. Inhale and exhale. Coming back down. Nice, you guys. And two more. Inhale and exhale. The chin nods. Really just feeling that one vertebra at a time motion and deepening the abdominals as you come up and over the feet. Inhale and again, exhale, belly button buttons to the spine as we come down. reaching through the fingers, oppositional energy always working. Come all the way down and bring the arms down to the sides. Excellent. So we're going to take it into rollover, and if you've got the low back stuff going on, take it easy. Even just lifting a little bit is fine. You can also take it into some bridge work, you know, just to keep that rolling through the spine. Okay, go to whatever your point of control is, your limit is. Okay, and here we go. Legs are long, toes are pointed, feet are parallel, arms long at the side. Inhale, exhale. Use the lower abdominals, start lifting those hips up and over. Looking at your thighs here, stay lifted. Don't sink down or collapse. Flex the feet and separate the legs, and we roll that through right down the center of the spine. And feet together, legs together, point the toes. Inhale and exhale, up and over. Flex, we separate, and we roll that down. Good control. We've got two more. Legs together, point the toes, inhale. And we exhale, coming up and over. Nice. Flex, separate, and roll down. Lots of control here. And feet together, legs together, inhale. And exhale, last one, up and over. Now, added on to this, if you can, go ahead and bring your toes to the floor. Stretch through the back of the legs. Lift up, inhale, and we exhale to roll back down with a separated leg. And legs together, feet together. Knees come into tabletop position. Grab a hold of your hamstrings. And rolling up to a seated position. Yes. And now rolling like a ball is just a lovely spine massage. And that's what we're going into next. So let's start actually with our feet a little further away from us and our hands on our hamstrings. Sitting tall, we inhale and exhale to pull and tilt that pelvis a little bit toward us as we roll down. Now feel everything active. You're only going to go down as far as if you take your arms away. The abdominals stay put, stay solid, okay? And inhale, and we exhale to C-curve forward. And then restack the spine up nice and tall, sitting on the sit bones. And again, inhale, and we exhale again. Rolling toward the low back, holding the abdominals in tight. Inhale, and exhale, C-curve forward. And restack it up. One more time, inhale and exhale. Wherever that point of control is for you, where you're not struggling, but it's a challenge. Inhale, exhale, and C-curve forward. You are in control of the motion, and lift up nice and tall. And we're gonna take it right into rolling like a ball. So pulling yourself in tight like a ball and holding onto the front of your shins. The toes come up first. You're gonna take your body into that C curve, making sure that your shoulders don't go up your ears. Keep those scapulas sliding down the back, chin tucked toward the chest. You're only gonna roll to your shoulder blades, okay? Here we go, inhale. And we exhale to roll back. And we roll right back up and balance on our sit bones. Inhale, exhale, roll it back. And roll it up, hold. We'll do two more, inhale, exhale, stay tucked nice and tight here. And roll it up. And again, back and up. Now we're gonna take it as slow as we can and roll back. Inhale and exhale, roll back, 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 control it. And we pause here, the head stays lifted, we're still tucked. And we're gonna extend our left leg out. And I'm actually gonna have you take your palms and press onto the front of the knee for single leg stretch. Inhale and exhale, reestablish the abdominals, pull them in tight. And we're gonna press that knee away from us as it comes in. And we switch and we press. And switch and reach. And switch and reach. Good, switch and reach. Switch and reach. Taking it up to pace a little more now with a good. Reaching long through the toes. couple more. Stay lifted and bring both knees in, this time touching the outside of either knee for double leg stretch. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, sweep it all back in. Inhale, reach long. Exhale in. Inhale, exhale, pull it in. Good. Last two. And pull it all in. Good. And one. And in. Excellent, you guys. And then we're going to extend our left leg down, right leg up, holding onto the calf and the hamstring. If you need a rest down on the head, do. Otherwise, stay lifted. And we pulse toward us and switch. Pulse, switch. Single straight leg. Beautiful. Keep that leg as long as you can. Good, both legs up. Hands go behind the head. If you need a break, again with the head, you can take it down. Otherwise, stay lifted. And we inhale, exhale, take the legs down again to that point where the abdominals stay in. Inhale, lift, and exhale down. Inhale, lift, exhale down. And last three. Last two. And last one. And knees bent, head can go down, finally. And bring the arms down to the sides. Bring the feet down and separate them again, hip distance. So I'm not gonna do crisscross, the traditional one, but I am gonna do a little pulsing up, which I think actually gets into the abdominals and the side body muscles a little more deeply. So we're gonna bring our right hand behind our head and our left one up, reaching toward the ceiling. As we inhale, we exhale to lift and then rotate toward the outside of the right knee. Now keeping the left hip down and solid, okay? And then we pulse up, little micro movements. We reach to the outside of that right knee. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. And come down to center and switch hands. Right arm lifts up, fingertips reach to the ceiling, inhale. Exhale, lift, rotate, and now we're on the left side, and we pulse up, one, two, three. Keep those pulses going, still keeping that right side down. Good. So the smaller the movement, oddly, with this one, the more intense it can feel. So really honing in on certain muscles here. And bring it down. And resting for a moment, you deserve it. So let's do a little stretch here while we rest, a little active recovery. Let's take our right ankle and cross it over the left knee and bringing that leg toward us to stretch. And release. And other side, left and lift. And release. And lengthening the legs out long on the mat, flex the feet, arms come up, inhale, exhaling to tuck the chin toward the chest and peel the spine up away from the mat, one vertebra at a time, stretching over those feet, inhale and exhale to re-stack up and relax it down. Ah, now we're finally sitting up. How does everybody feel? Y'all look good. Yay. So go ahead and separate the legs just to either side of your mat for spine stretch forward. So this is a very active, it's a stretch, yes, but it's also a very active abdominal exercise. So the arms come out in front of us, shoulder blades slide down the back, neck is long and in neutral. Inhaling, and as we exhale, those muscles all pull in and that force it around your spine as you round forward. And it's as if you're rounding over a big beach ball. And you're reaching between those feet, those deeply flexed feet. Inhale, exhale, pull the abdominals in even tighter as we re-stack the spine up, tall. And again, inhale, exhale, and again, rounding forward, reach. Inhale, exhale, deepen the abdominals and re-stack up. And we'll do one more, inhale. And exhale, round, reach. Feel the scapula slide away from each other. Inhale and exhale, re-stack up and feel them come back together here. Nice, and release that. I'm gonna turn towards you guys for song. So legs are going to be separated into a V. Arms are going to come out reaching long. So this is a really good lesson in oppositional energy. And what I mean by that is when we rotate to the side, we're reaching forward and we're reaching back, that back palm. Okay, so really think about stretching the body long. Here we go, inhale, sitting tall. And we exhale to rotate, round down, leg is fine, stretch. Reach for that pinky toe and that back hand and knee, pulse, pulse, pulse. Inhale to restack and center our body. Exhale to twist, reach through both hands and one, two, three, and lift and center. Exhale to twist and round down, spine stretch, and one, two, three, inhale, lift, center, rotate, and again, round down, reach, one, two, three, inhale, center, we'll do one more each side, we twist and reach, one, two, three, inhale, lift and center, and exhale, last one, and saw off the pinky toe, and lift up, not really, but you know, and bring it down, and coming into open leg rocker. Lots of different layers for this movement. Of course, you can stay in a teaser-like position with this one. That's actually really challenging. If you want to try the full expression of the movement, you are free to. Most of you know what this exercise is. So we'll bring ourselves into that tabletop position first. So you're sitting up on your sit bones. You're in that, that teaser spine, so it's neutral and straight and not exactly rounded. You have a slight roundness there, but we're gonna actually now hold on to the outside of our calf if that's available to you. And we're gonna lengthen our right leg out. And we're gonna bring it in. And the left, and in. And one more each side, lengthen. And lengthen, beautiful. Now if both are available, go ahead and lengthen them out in that V. The toes are pointed, we're holding on. We round back, only to our shoulder blades when we go back. Here we go, inhale, exhale, and tilt the pelvis up to roll back. We roll back up, we balance on the sit bones, reach through those toes, make it happen. Inhale, and again, exhale, roll it back. Lift up, up, up. Balance through that spine. Yes, through the pelvic bowl. And inhale, exhale, and again, roll it down the back. And lift up, 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 hold. Yes, nice job, you guys. Bring the legs together and bring the feet down. And bring ourselves up to a seated position. Yay, good job. So here we go, you guys. We're gonna take it into all fours position. So starting with just our balance movement here. And noticing where the hands are, which they should be right underneath the shoulders, and the knees right underneath the hips. From here, inhale around the spine, and then I wanna see you exhale without moving any bones. Just the muscles move in. Let's do one more, just like that. Inhale. And exhale to move the muscles around that neutral spine. Right from here, opposite arm and leg go out. So right arm, left leg. Reach it out and then lift it up. And again, reaching long, lifting out of this, not sinking down. Stay lifted, pelvis stable. And bring that in with control. And other side. Inhale and exhale to lengthen and lift. Balance, balance, balance. And bring it down and in. Good. Let's add on to that movement. Inhale, exhale. Muscles pull in. We extend right arm, left leg out and up. And right from here, nothing moves except the arm and leg. I'm going to tap it down. Two, three, four, five, and six, and bring it in. Inhale, exhale again. Try not to shift too much weight to that left leg. We lift up, and then we tap down. One, two, very stable core, very stable center. And last one, six, and bring it in. Now you can stay up on your hands, and I know that sometimes that gets a little irritating to the wrists. So if you feel you need to, you can come down onto the forearms for the next series, just a little back leg work that we're gonna do. So from here, we're gonna lengthen the right leg out. We're gonna lift it up. It's in parallel right now. And we're gonna take it down. We're gonna tap, tap, lift. Tap, tap, lift. Tap, tap. Tap, tap, lift. Feel the glutes working here. Pull the leg up. Tap, tap, lift. Tap, tap. Tap, tap. Good. One more set. And bring it down. Leg is long. We're going to rotate slightly. And we're going to kick it up for arabesque. And two. And three. And four. And five. And six. Hold it here for 10 pulses. One, two. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now we bend the knee in attitude, still rotate from the hip, and we lift up for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Bring it all down and in. And other leg. Here we go. Inhale and exhale. Lengthen the left leg out. Lift it up. And then we tap, tap, lift. Tap, tap. Tap, tap, lift. Good. Tap, tap, lift. Make it a dynamic lift. Lift. One more. Lift. Hold the leg up. Rotate out from the hip. And we're going to bring the turkey. Bring our toes down. And lift up to kick for arabesque. One, two, three, four, five. And six, and hold up here, and then pulse. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Bring our knee in a little bit closer to us, and I want you to feel this right here, okay? So attitude, we're gonna lift up for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Bring it down. And go ahead and sit back in a child's pose to give that those wrists a little break. And then we're gonna come up, you guys, up to our knees before we go down into some extension work. And just a little thigh stretch, okay? So working the quads and the glutes here. The arms are gonna come out in front of us. We're inhaling nice and tall, exhaling to draw everything in, and then moving like a board back. Now you will feel this here, of course. So if you feel it too much, activate the back body more. And then lift up. And again, on our exhale, we lean back and we lift up. Adding on the arms, we're gonna inhale, exhale. As we come back, the arms are gonna come toward the ears. Ooh, that intensifies it. And bring them back. And four more, just like that. Hinge, lift the arms, and bring it back. Last two. Inhale forward. Last one. And lift. And the arms come down. And we go down onto our stomachs for swan prep. Here we go. Hands underneath the shoulders. Legs together, activating the middle back. But before we do that, pulling the abdominals up and in. We inhale to lengthen through the crown of the head and exhale to lift, pressing into the hands, lift. Hold, feel the length and bring it down. Inhale, lengthen first and then lift up. And our last one here, lengthen, lift it up, and coming down, separating our legs behind us in a V, and our arms in front of us in a V. We're lengthening through all of those limbs with a nice deep inhale. On our exhale, we lift them all the way up. Ideally, thighs are off the mat, belly is pulled in, arms are lifted high, and we paddle for swimming. The core is stable as we reach through the fingers and toes and paddle. Breathe. Looking down at our mat to keep the neck long and the integrity of the whole spine there intact. And paddle. And release it all the way down. And go ahead and sit back again in a child's pose. Really stretching through the low back. We'll take it also to a stretch over to the right. So you're just gonna walk your hands over and press the left hip down. And walk it over to the left and press the right hip down. And we're gonna come to center, coming up onto our hands and knees for one final cat-cow stretch. I wanna leave Terry with a really nice stretch too here if the low back is feeling any tension. Just taking it into our normal cat-cow, arching the back up and then releasing that and opening, widening the sits bones here and then bring it up again. And lengthening through the sits bones and arching the back, tucking the pelvis slightly. And coming into the neutral spine, and then it's almost as if you've got a paintbrush attached to your low back. And I want you to draw circles with that paintbrush on the back wall, circling through the pelvic bowl. And we'll go one direction and the other. I had one of my instructors call this sexy cat. And it really does feel nice though. And we release it there. And cycling series, guys, here we go. So bring it down, whichever side you want to start with. I am partial to resting my head in my hand. You can come all the way down if you'd like. And if you want like even more an advanced workout, you both hands behind the head. Okay, but I'm gonna stay here today. So I want your feet at the front corner of your mat, your hips stacked, your shoulders stacked, and your stabilizing hand in front to remind you to keep the abdominals pulled in. And we're just gonna do nice kicks first, so we're gonna lift up and pull down for two counts. Toes are pointed, Pilates feet, and pull down for two counts. We kick for one, and pull down for two, and kick for one, and pull down for two. And again, kick, and kick, one, two, and kick, and last one, kick and down and rest it here. Lengthen that top leg out, then lift it up, flex the foot, flexing to kick forward and pointing to kick back. However far you can do this leg, you can move this leg without the pelvis wobbling. That's what you want to do. Ideally, you don't want the pelvis wobbling back and forth. You're staying in between those two panes of glass with the movement of the leg. And flex forward, point it back, and flex, good, and point. And last one, and point it back. The leg is gonna come to center and release down, and we're gonna scoot our legs into the center of our mat now. Lengthen the top leg, lift it up, and we're gonna bicycle, so we're gonna bring our knee in, lengthen it out, and sweep it back. Knee bends, leg extends forward, we sweep it back and the leg stays just about hip level and sweep it back. And then we reverse that motion. We sweep back, scoop the leg forward, bend the knee and press the leg back. Scoop it forward, bend the knee and last one. Big giant bicycle. Excellent. And extend the leg out and relax it down. Now make sure that your heels are together. Your bottom toes are on your mat or the floor. And you're in a Pilates stance. One of my favorites, passe. So really working the inner thigh and working back here. We're rotated out. And we're gonna slide that big toe up the center of the leg. And then we're gonna just press it back out, coming heel to heel. And again, slide it up and press back. Heel to heel, start position, and a couple more. And press it out. And last one. And press it out, adding on. So we're gonna slide the big toe up, and then we're gonna lengthen, and then we're gonna squeeze it all lift, lengthen, and bring it down. Good. And up. Lengthen, développé, and squeeze the legs together. Last one. Up. Lengthen, and bring it down. And rest here for a moment. Beautiful, you guys. Pushing yourselves up. And the bottom leg is going to go in front. The top leg is going to go behind in that zigzag sort of leg position for mermaid. So holding on to that calf and lifting the arm and just arching the body over to stretch through. And up and all the way over to the other side. Stretch. Still moving in between those two panes of glass. One plane of movement. And bring it up. Beautiful. And then we'll stretch the other side after this side leg series on this side too. So coming down. Stacking the body appropriately. Shoulders, hips, feet at first coming to the front corner of the mat, and we are in Pilates feet. Other hand in front. Here we go. We kick up and hold up for two counts. One and pull down. One, two, and kick. And one, two, and kick. And one, two, and kick. One, two, two more. Beautiful. And then bring that leg hip level. Flex the foot. Flex to kick forward. Point to kick back. And we flex and point. And flex and point. And stable pelvis. Nice job, you guys. And forward and back. Forward and back. And last one. Leg comes to the center down. We scoot our legs back to the center of the mat. Leg lengthens and lifts, bending the knee in for our bicycle, lengthening forward, sweeping the leg back, and bringing it through. And making that as fluid as we can. Reach back and in, reach. And reversing that, press it back, scoop the leg, and in, and back, and in. Good, last one. And bring it in, that leg extends out. Pilates feet, heels together, and sliding the big toe up the center and pressing it back down. And two, and down, and three. Feeling the glutes, the side glute muscles here too, working. And down, and again, last one. And then we add on our développé. And we pull it up, and we lengthen the leg, and we squeeze those legs together. And pull, and lengthen, and down, and side passe, and lengthen, good, and down, and last one, and lengthen, and down, and release, and then we push ourselves up for mermaid on this side. So of course that top leg now goes back, other leg, bottom leg is in front, holding on to our shin, and coming up and over. Not sinking down, bringing the chest forward, opening, opening, and all the way down to the other side. And stretch. Good, you guys. Oh my goodness. Okay. And bringing it up. So we have plenty of time for teaser. Always, right? So here we go. We're coming onto our sit bones. I like to start teaser sitting up. So we will do that today. And go ahead, and at first, holding on to our hamstrings, we'll do a teaser progression, okay? So our first teaser is just our teaser lift, okay? So we're getting into position. Inhale and exhale. We lean back. We lift the left leg up, and then the right. And we lengthen, if that's available to you, and then we reach our arms out. So we're reaching, looking over those feet. So the head stays on top of the spine. And just holding and breathing here. You got this. If you need to soften your knees, please do. And then we're gonna gently and control bring ourselves back in. Ooh, teaser two. We're gonna do a little leg movement with this one. Inhale. exhale again, leaning back, left, right, lengthen, arms up. Here we lower the legs and we lift. And I want you to feel that happening here. And down. And last one. And in. And lift. Yes, you guys, good job. Teaser three, we add on some arm movement. Here we go, inhale. And we exhale. Again, lean it back. Left, right, lengthen, arms up. And here we're just gonna come down and up. And down and up. Lower body stable. Last one. We hold, we hold. We shake and we hold. And we bring it all down and in. And we release that. And we're gonna come up for a little bit of a dancer stretch, just a lunge. So coming up and bringing our left leg forward and our right leg in a lunge here and back. And I want you to just take your body forward to stretch through the quadricep. Taking both hands, putting it on either side of that left foot and rolling the toes of the back leg, the right leg, and lifting up here and stretching. And then we're gonna lengthen the front leg out and round our spine to stretch through here. And then we're gonna walk our hands to center. Wide legs here, wide feet, and just press our body forward. Feel the stretch in the inner thighs. And then walking it to the other side. We'll start up with that scissor stretch. So both legs are long. Our body is arched over that front leg as much as it can be. If you need to bend your knee, absolutely do. And now our back leg is still lifted as we lunge forward and dive deeper into the inner thigh. And then go ahead and drop that knee down. Bring our hands up to the front leg and just sinking down a little bit more. And taking the hands away, an extension stretch here. So clasping the hands and opening the chest. And releasing all of that. And thank you so much, you guys.
Hi, it's Brooke. Thank you for spending your time with us. We truly hope that you enjoyed your class experience. Please follow us on your favorite social media platform. Like, subscribe, and book your next class. You can do that on our website or through our Reforming Foundations app. We'll see you next time.